Alright. So here is a Swan-Ganz catheter. As you can see, it doesn't have this syringe yet. But the hub is right there, near the shortest part. And the next one, which is the injectate. Then you have your next one, which is your PA distal. And the next one, you have your distal lumen, RV pacing infusion. I don't know if you can see that. And then finally, and then your thermistor. Okay, when you open it, you see the pins. So, once again, you got your small one, shortest one for the injection syringe. Then you have your proximal. Then you have your distal. Then you have your RV pacing and infusion. Then you have your thermistor. Okay, so those are it. And basically, that's how you have it. And then for this one, that's where we put our syringe. No more than a certain number. Okay, I don't think I can even go. See, there's a thing where I can't go any further than 1.5. See, there's a block, as you can tell. See, there's a block right there, so you can't go. You can only go up to 1.5. That's another safety measure. So here is where I can put that. Okay, but usually I would get air first. So right there, only 1.5. Right there, and I get the safety injector. Right there, okay? So here we go to hashtag this one. So 5, 4, 3, nothing yet. And then we go to 2, and as you can see, I don't see the port yet. So then here's 1, still no port, and then we go back to 4 and 3, and as you can see, these are a little bit more special because you have your port right there. And that is your distal port. And then you have your proximal port. You're right there. Okay. and finally go to 1 again. And then you have your balloon. Okay. So once again, from the beginning. So from the balloon, you have your, let me see, right there. So this is your IV port and the thermistor proximal. That's not it. Because we're missing the distal. The toxin. Oh, there. Let's see. No, that's it. Indications. No, I guess that is it. So, you got your balloon, proximal, thermistor, lumen, pacing, and then your thermistor, which is the longest, and the proximal is 30 centimeters out. RV port is 19, and the distal lumen is also, of course, at the very end. Okay, so the distal is at the very end. The RV port and the proximal, and the checks on the proximal, goes with the shortest one, so it's closest to you. So the one's on closest to you, so you've got your distal, most distal port, which is that hole right there. And then you've got your, let's see, RV port at 19 centimeters, so it would be the next one. This one with the 2 mark RV port. And then you got your proximal right there. And then it goes 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. So proximal, which was the closest hole, is going to be then injectable hub, this one. So this proximal hub. Wait, let's see. This is distal. That's at the very tip. This is the proximal injectate. So this proximal injectate will coincide with this one. #3. And then this one will coincide with the distal lumen hub. So that would be this one. Okay? And now for the finale, this one goes with the balloon. So as I inject, you'll see the balloon pop up. As you can see, right there. You see, not even with this much, with only like barely half a cc, has a balloon already injected. If I keep going, it just gets bigger and bigger, and it's just way big, and that's all the way at the end. And you never want to leave this open. I mean, you never really want to leave this inflated and then leave it there. You get your reading and then you deflate right away. Okay? All right.